Good morning, Drive Heads. That's a new name I came up for my listening club of the Drive Time program. Well, it's a special good morning to you episode of the Drive Time Hour with your host, Vernon Howl. That's me. We're doing a little AM commute drive. It's 8:56 in the morning here in New Jersey, and we're going to work. So, usually I do these, here's the thing is, my day is pretty standard almost all the time. You get up, go to work, I usually roll in around 9, I'm going to be a couple minutes late today, not a big deal. Lunchtime, I leave it around 12:45 usually, on average, let's say 12:45-ish, and I go home. Spend about an hour lunch, go back. So I'm in my car 4 times a day, typically 6-7 minutes to, if there's a little bit of traffic around where I work, so 10 minutes usually. Usually not much longer. 10 minutes is the upper side of how long it usually takes me to get to work. This car in front of me is doing some weird stuff. They've got a George W. Bush W sticker from 2004. So that's neat. They have the blinker. Okay, they just turned the blinker off. It had been on for a long time. They're going very slow. That's an old Republican person in a Outback Legacy, which is actually, that's a pretty nice car, I think. I'm not too familiar. Outback, is that a Subaru? Maybe, I think, I'm not sure. So I had a bit of an epiphany last night and today. I wrote a poem, and what you're seeing now is my notebook, which is a book called Level. All my notebooks and little things that I jot things down are the in themselves bigger books that will soon be one day for sale on vernonhowl.com. This book is from a current book I'm working called Level, and it's basically unfinished poems and certain things. But the poem you're reading now, if you're watching this on a laptop, if you're watching this on a desktop, this is going to be hard to do. But if you're watching this on a laptop on the YouTube.com or on VernonHowl.com on the YouTube embeddable player, which I've uploaded the sound file to, and the accompanying picture to this morning is a poem I wrote called The Key to Happiness, and I'm driving right now with one hand and no seatbelt on, and my other hand's holding this on my iPhone, speaking into it, recording the talk show, Vernon Howl's Drive Time, episode 4A, the 23rd day of May, and what you see there is the poem. So if you do have a laptop, what you can do is, I think it's cut off a little bit, but if you turn your laptop sideways, if you're looking at it, I would assume just turn to your right so it's on its side. That's not going to mess up the audio of what I'm saying too badly. So you should be able to, if you follow those instructions, just turn it to the on its side to the right. As we almost got into an accident there, you should be able to see. That was close. This car, some asshole in BMW just buzzed me. It was not too. He thought I was a little bit over. Okay, but anyway, if you turn it over, you can kind of read the gist of the poem is to. And I had this epiphany that it's called The Key to Happiness, and the only real key to happiness that you need to be concerned with is to fighting to stop you the urge to do things that are unproductive and that you know are just filling up the void, so to speak, in otherwise what would be considered your life. So what does that mean? I allude to the show River Monsters from the Animal Planet show River Monsters on this poem. I allude to it. And I like River Monsters. It's a good show. But my point is that there's never any real reason to watch River Monsters. Because unless you're in a hospital bed. So unless you are basically confined to an area where there's little to do and you're probably, you're maybe succumbing to a depression that is truly out of your control and beyond your will, and that's what I'm saying is some sort of terminal disease or some sort of painful injury that you might have sustained where you have to be in a hospital bed. And there's actually an asterisk to where I reference River Monsters, the asterisk is actually leads to a part of the poem. I'm gonna type this poem, I think, and publish it on my website today. I think it's pretty good. So the asterisk says, write another poem, titled, "Does hospital cable have Animal Planet?" I thought that was kind of funny. So I thought that was like a lighthearted parenthetical footnote. Not parenthetical, but like a footnote reference to give it some humor. Because you really have nothing. You shouldn't take anything too seriously, including this show, even this talk show, or any poetry in general, or any form of art. You really should kind of relax on that. So that was the poem is basically saying like if you can't, there's no reason ever to just sit idly by and watch TV or really play video games. And I think what happens is we've been tricked by a lot of culture and mass culture in general, has kind of formed this entity that is a force that changes the way we really are supposed to think. So we'll really honestly be thinking, well, I'm doing what I want to be doing. I'm playing this video game. I'm watching this Animal Planet program. I'm doing X, Y, or Z. And when in reality, these are just, you're just filling up moments of that you are awake in life with nothingness. There's a time and a place for I think a limited amount of any of that kind of stuff, but when it becomes a nightly activity, there's just no one, and I'm not saying people don't truly feel that it is worthy and it is worthwhile, but it's a lie, and the key is to fight that lie and fight against that urge. And to do things and then so what? So then that's just step one. But there really isn't any step two. Step two is just that once you've completed that, you'll see. It'll be there. It'll be self-evident. It really will. I believe in that. You won't need to. There is no step two. So once you fight that, as I say in the end of the poem, the door will just kind of gently slide open as if pushed by a gentle breeze. I think was the line I used. And that's it. We can expound on this more. I think this was a good talk. Okay.